In this video, we'll see how to build entire hybrid search from scratch by using Elasticsearch and SBERT machine learning models. So we'll cover four major things in this video. First, what exactly is hybrid search? Then we'll see what exactly is reciprocal rank fusion. Then we'll discuss about why hybrid search is necessary, why we can't just use only lexical search and only semantic search, why we have to combine the results and make it a hybrid search. Then at the end, we'll implement hybrid search in the code. So without any further ado, let's begin. So what exactly is hybrid search? Hybrid search is nothing but the combination of results coming from semantic search and lexical search. And we combine these two results using technique called reciprocal rank fusion. So I'm assuming you already know about semantic search, but if you don't, you can refer my this video. I'll put the link in the description box. So now we'll see what exactly is reciprocal rank fusion. So reciprocal rank fusion is a technique by which we can combine the results coming from both semantic search and lexical search. So in this example, let's say we have results from vector search, which basically is a semantic search. So these are the results in these order. So document 3 at rank 1, document 2 at rank 2, document 1 at rank 3, and document 4 at rank 4. And these results are coming from vector search. Similarly, from lexical, document 2 at rank 1, document 1 at rank 2, and document 4 at 3, and document 3 at 4. Now we'll calculate the reciprocal rank for each document. So for document 3 and document 2, the rank is 1 by 1, reciprocal rank is 1 by 1. For document 2, reciprocal rank is 1 by 2. For document 1, reciprocal rank is 1 by 2. And similarly for 1 and 4 here, the reciprocal rank is 1 by 3. And for document 4 and 3, reciprocal rank is 1 by 4. Now we'll see how we can combine these. So if you see here, document 1, the rank, or I should say reciprocal rank, was 1 by 3 in the first case, because document 1 was at rank 3 from the vector search, and it is at rank 2 in the lexical search. Document 1 is at rank 2 in the lexical search, and that's why we'll say 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2, and the final score is 0.83. Similarly, for document 2, it was at rank 2 in the vector search results, and it was at rank 1 in the lexical search results. So that's why 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1, and the final score is 1.5. Document 3, it was at rank 1 in the vector search results, and it was at rank 4th in the lexical search results, if you see. And that's why 1 by 1 plus 1 by 4. Basically, we are adding the reciprocal rank of a particular document from both the techniques, semantic and lexical one. And we are calculating the final score. For document 4, the final score is 0.58. And then we'll order these in the descending order of the score. So maximum score, document 2, then document 3, document 1, and document 4. These are the final hybrid search results coming from both the combination of vector search and lexical search. So reciprocal rank fusion has a formula as well, like I elaborate one, 1 by k plus rank d. So this rank d is basically rank of document, and this k is a constant. In most databases, this value is equal to 60. For the explanation's sake, I have omitted the k from our explanation. I have just taken the reciprocal, and this is good enough for us for the scope of this video. Now we'll see why hybrid search is necessary at first place, why we can't just work with only lexical or only semantic search. So I have created a couple of examples here. So we'll see e-commerce example. If the end user is searching with the query, affordable wireless headphones with noise cancellation, and if we are using only lexical search, it will match with products with exact keywords like affordable wireless headphones and noise cancellation. But it will miss words like budget, Bluetooth earphones, or ANC, because it's just a lexical search. It is not taking into account the meaning of the word. Now comes to semantic part. So if you are using only semantic search, it will retrieve the product related to headphones and noise cancellation, even if the description does not explicitly include the word affordable. Second thing, includes premium headphones, because the model might generalize wireless headphones with noise cancellation as a concept, ignoring the affordability part, because this is a semantic and this is not very word to word accurate, and that's why it can include those kinds of headphones which are not affordable or not a budget headphones in the search results. To tackle this, we use hybrid search. Basically, we combine the results from these two techniques and come up with the final results, and so that it will match with both kinds of documents, and it will not miss the documents which should have not been missed. Everything will be much clearer when we see the code example. So without any further ado, let's start the coding part here. So let me open this file. So I have created this file, and let me show you one by one. So first, this is the data. This is the e-commerce data. So these are the 10 different kinds of headphones with their description, with their price, and we are adding some tags to them. So this is the data which we are going to use. If you see, we have affordable headphones as well, and budget friendly as well. So if you see here, we have affordable ones as well and budget friendly as well. And we'll see how these play out in the hybrid and the lexical search. Now I will define the mapping of the index in Elasticsearch for this data. So first we are putting in the product name here. So this is the product name, type is text, and we are using the standard analyzer. Description, again text, it will be standard. Price will be float, tags will be text, analyzer again will be standard. And we are adding one new field here, which we'll call description vector, because we are converting description into a vector embedding. And type will be dense vector. Dimensions will be 384, because the model which we are using, the SBERT embedding model, it will create the 384 dimension vector. And the similarity technique here, we will use the L2 norm. L2 norm is nothing but the Euclidean distance, which we use to calculate the distance between two vectors. We can use cosine similarity as well here, but right now I'm using L2 norm. We will import this mapping variable into our final code in the hybrid search file. So here is the hybridsearch.py file, and I'm importing all this. Let me press shift enter. Here I'm using the interactive mode of the VS Code. I'm using cursor basically. So in both, you can open the settings and enable this interactive mode so that you can run these lines of code just like you run in Jupyter Notebook. So I'll just select this, press shift enter again. Here I'm trying to connect to my Elasticsearch server, which is already running in the background. So this is nothing but I'm just putting in my CA cert file path here. This is the username and this is the password. This is not a good practice to put passwords like this, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm putting it like this. And here is the model for the creation of embeddings. So we are using sentence transformer library, and we are defining this model here. Then we will define the embedding function. This embedding function will take the input of text and it will convert this text into embeddings. It will return model.encode text and it will convert the embedding, and it will give us the final result in the list format, basically the list of numbers. Let me define this function as well. Now we'll create the index in Elasticsearch and we'll name it hybrid search v1. I'll just run this and we will create the index here. So I'm just basically deleting the index if it already exists and creating it. And here, if you see, mapping equal to mappings, and this mappings is coming from this file which we have created earlier. So now we have created the index. Now let's import the data from the CSV file into the data variable. We can just select this variable as well and press shift enter to see what exactly is present in this data variable. You can see these are the headphones which we have taken as a reference. Now I'm converting the data into Elasticsearch format. So basically this is the format in which Elasticsearch takes the data. So I'm converting this pandas data frame into Elasticsearch compatible data here, nothing much. And if you see at line number 63, this description vector part, I am calling the getEmbedding function and I'm passing the description and converting this description text into embedding and saving it in this field. Now we will index everything into the Elasticsearch. Indexing is basically sending the data into Elasticsearch. So I'm using this helper module from the Elasticsearch itself on top. If you see here, what it does is basically we don't have to send each row separately to Elasticsearch. We can just combine everything at once, and in one call we can send everything to Elasticsearch database. Now as data is placed into Elasticsearch, we can search the data. So let's define lexical search function, which will search the results based on the lexical search technique. Here in the body, if you see, I'm putting in the query which will multi-match with the results from product name and the description. So what will happen, whatever the input query from the user, it will get matched lexically with the product name column as well. On the right, if you see this product name column, so whatever words present here, it will get matched with the input query from the user lexically first. Then the input query will get matched with the description column as well. In the semantic, we will only take the description vector part because we are only converting description into vector, not the product names. So let's just define this function. This function is doing nothing but just giving us the lexical result. Now we will define the semantic search results. So semantic search results will also take query, input query, top k, basically how many number of results we want to fetch from the Elasticsearch. Same here in the lexical one as well. We are passing in the top k variable how many results we want to fetch, like top 3, top 5. So in semantic search, I am first calculating the embedding of the input query given by the end user, and then this query embedding I will pass inside the query for the Elasticsearch. So here I'm just taking the cosine similarity between the query embedding and the description vector, and we are calculating the semantic search results here. So let me define this complete function once. If you want to know more details about the semantic search, you can check out the video on my channel. I will put the link in the description as well. And now comes the reciprocal rank fusion part. So here I'm defining this k equal to 60, taking both the results from lexical as well as semantic, and then combining them both using the reciprocal rank fusion technique, which we have discussed earlier. So let me just define this function. And in this function, what exactly is happening? Basically, I'm just processing the lexical results first. I'm calculating the RRF score for each document from the lexical result. Same thing is happening with semantic as well. Calculating the RRF score for each semantic search result as well. And then here I'm combining these results and sorting them based on the descending order of the reciprocal rank fusion score. So let's define this function once again. So this calculation, everything can happen within Elasticsearch as well. Elasticsearch provides you with these API. But for the explanation, I have created this function explicitly to show what exactly is happening inside. Now comes the function remove duplicates and re-rank. So let's say from the results coming from lexical as well as semantic, there are some results which are common in both the results. So this function is basically removing those results. I'll just run this as well. Now comes the final function, which is hybrid search, which will show us this results. We are just taking the lexical hit first, then semantic hits, and then combining the results using reciprocal rank fusion. In the hybrid search, we are taking query input and we are defining the lexical top k, like how many results we want from lexical search, and then we are defining how many results we want from the semantic search results. So let's see the example. So if user is searching for input query affordable wireless headphones with ANC, so let's see what are the results coming from lexical search. So these are the results on the right. If you see, lexical search is giving us results affordable wireless headphones, travel friendly ANC headphones, and gaming headset with mic. It is coming because the description contains the noise cancelling, noise isolating part. And that's why this third result is coming. Now we'll see what semantic is giving us. So if we search with the semantic results, it is giving us the budget Bluetooth earphones. This budget Bluetooth earphone, this result was missing from the lexical search results. If you see, we have affordable one, travel, and gaming one, but we are missing the budget one from this. And in the semantic one, if you see, we have budget one, affordable one, and the premium one, but we are missing the one which contains the ANC in the name, travel friendly ANC headphone. And these are the trade-offs which we have to make when we are using only lexical or only semantic. And that's why we combine these results using hybrid search. We'll run this and we will see the hybrid search results. We have affordable one, budget one as well. We have ANC one, we have the gaming one, and we have the premium noise cancelling one as well. And if you see, these three and these three have one result common, which is affordable one. Lexical search also contains this affordable one, and semantic one also contains this affordable. And that is why we have removed the duplicate and we are only getting five results. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 here. So here I'm only taking the examples of wireless headphones and we are only taking the domain of e-commerce, but there are other domains as well, like healthcare. So in healthcare, let's say user is searching for symptoms of vitamin D deficiency in children. So if you use only lexical search, it will matches the articles with symptoms, vitamin D deficiency in children, but it can miss results using terms like pediatric cases of hypovitaminosis D or low vitamin D in kids, because these words are not lexically matching with the input query. In semantic, it can capture the broader concept of vitamin D deficiency and its symptoms, but might bring articles discussing adults or unrelated nutrients. So it can give you the results of symptoms of vitamin D deficiency in adults as well, or it can give you the symptoms of vitamin A deficiency in children. So semantic can go haywire also, because we don't have much control in semantic, and it also depends upon the model which we are using. And that's why we use hybrid search. Similarly, in legal search as well, this is the example, intellectual property law for digital assets. So in lexical, it will match with intellectual property law only and digital assets only, but it can miss the discussion using terms like copyright for NFTs or IP regulations for virtual goods. If you are using only semantic, finds conceptually related results about intellectual property and technology, but it can risk retrieving overly broad content like IP laws for traditional media as well. And that is why we will use hybrid search to increase the accuracy or the relevance of the search results. So before ending this video, I want to give you two resources from Elastic. So this is basically the page, and it will give you how the RRF is implemented in Elasticsearch and how you can use hybrid search by using APIs, which is provided internally out of the box from Elastic. So these are the two good resources which I found regarding RRF and hybrid search. So I will put these two links in the description box as well. If you have any questions or comments, please put down in the comment box. Hope you found this video helpful. Thank you so much.